find out what we
need. They needed to locate the murderer. And after viewing the area, investigators were not optimistic.
Frankly, when I went there and noticed where she did fall out, I thought there was little or no chance of ever recovering yet.
Members of the search and rescue team from the San Luis Obispo County Sheriff's Department were brought out to the site. After surveying the area, the team meticulously mapped out their mission. They double-checked all of their equipment to ensure their safety, and then geared up. It was now up to them to rappel down the perilous cliff and search the beach below for the weapon believed to have been used to kill John and Lori Rainwater. As investigators in Atascadero, California, continued searching for evidence in the slayings of John and Lori Rainwater, they finally got a break. An informant admitted that at the instruction of a boyfriend, Dennis Wayne Witt, she had thrown the murder weapon off a 300-foot cliff into the Pacific Ocean. Though finding the weapon seemed like a long shot, the search and rescue team slowly made their way down the sheer cliff. Because of the treacherous conditions, it took the two-man team nearly 3 hours to reach the bottom. Once there, they began searching for the gun. For over an hour, the search turned up nothing. But then, under some rubbish, they found what appeared to be the frame of a .38 caliber Smith & Wesson revolver. Though it was badly damaged, police believed they had found the murder weapon. The team made their way back up the cliff and turned the gun over to Investigator Hannigan. For him, its value as evidence was questionable.
Looking down the barrel of this weapon, this was covered completely in rust. Frankly, I didn't think we were going to be able to get any type of ballistic help at all with this.
Police sent the gun to the California Department of Justice crime lab. Technicians managed to reassemble and clean the gun enough to test fire. The test fired bullets were then compared to those recovered from John and Lori Rainwater. The markings left on the bullets as they traveled down the barrel of the gun matched in some areas, but not all. Investigators were building a good case, but they were still a long way from proving murder.
Here's what's coming up on the Justice Network.
If you, like many people, are covered by both Medicare and your state's Medicaid, here's something important to know. Now you can get even more health benefits than you already have. It's the United Healthcare Dual Complete Plan. To find out if you or someone you care about is eligible, it's easy. Call now to talk with us. We can explain it all and answer any questions. Medicaid gives you benefits, and Medicare gives you some too. But a dual complete plan can add even more benefits and features compared to original Medicare. You'll have lots of doctors and hospitals to choose from, plus prescription drug coverage. And depending on where you live, you can enjoy other benefits too. Like dental care, vision coverage, and rides to and from your doctor or hospital. You can even get a health products catalog with credits you can use to shop for everyday things, like vitamins, oral health items, and first aid kits. And best of all, with this plan, there's no additional cost to you. Remember, if you have Medicare and Medicaid, chances are you could get a dual complete plan. So call now to talk with us and learn more. Or ask to have a licensed agent visit your home and take you through everything step by step. We know healthcare can be confusing. United Healthcare can straighten things out. With 40 years of experience, you can count on us to be there all along the way. With a dual complete plan, you can have a wide choice of doctors to choose from, better prescription drug coverage, dental and vision coverage too, all at no additional cost. You have Medicare, you have Medicaid. You may be eligible for dual complete. So call the number on your screen now to see if you're eligible, or to enroll in a dual complete plan from United Healthcare.
Police turned to their informant for help. They wanted to try and coax away a little confession. They asked his girlfriend to wear a wire and record conversations with him in prison. She agreed to cooperate, despite the danger of being exposed.
I'm convinced that the informant's motivation was only to see that justice was done. At no time during the investigation did the informant ask for any leniency on any pending criminal case she had, nor did she ask for any type of reward that was out there. It was only to see that justice was done.
During their conversations, Webb made no overt references to the murderers. He believed that the correctness was recorded all conversations.